Welcome to Jay's Sticky Crown. If you're watching my channel for the first time, please subscribe. Come, let's get into the video. In this video, I'm going to respond to your most recent questions posted on the comment sections. So please continue to post your questions on the comment sections and I'm happy to respond to your questions. Also, please make a note that I am answering these questions to the best of my knowledge along with relevant data points and evidences from different social forums and contacts by closely following the Australian PR visa processing timelines. Note, the responses here are outcome of my analysis and my updates on the timeline and cutoff points may vary case to case on a timely manner. Let us move on to the question number 1. The question is from Shane and she's asking whether do you have any idea if early next year will Australia allow tourists already? Yes, there are plans to start the international travel with vaccination certificate and I have responded to her a month ago saying the same. As you all know, there are more than 30,000 Australians stranded outside of Australia. So soon they may start the international travel with the vaccination certificate and the dates are not yet finalized. But still there will be hotel quarantine for 14 days. Here is the most recent official update on this.
Travel could soon be back on the cards with plans to implement a COVID vaccination certificate for anyone wanting to move in or out of Australia. We'll go live to our political reporter Emma LaRouche in Canberra. Emma, good morning to you. What does this mean for hotel quarantine?
Good morning, Davina. Well, hotel quarantine arrangements are likely to remain in place for some time. One reason for this is that we don't know how effective a vaccine will be at preventing the transmission of COVID. The federal government is considering an international immunisation certificate for overseas visitors and returning Australians, as well as alternate quarantine arrangements, excuse me, if it is safe to do so. But we're being warned that it will take a very long time to return to some sort of pre-COVID normal, and a vaccine isn't a silver bullet.
Also, there may be a delay in this process due to increase in COVID cases due to this new EU. Let's hope for the best. Let us move on to the question number 2. It is from Shine and he's asking, for work experience documents, do we need to upload the documents only for the experience declared in UOI? Or all the work experience document prior to the travel? To answer to his question, it is always recommended to upload all the relevant documents to avoid CO contact or delay in the processing. Here is the evidence of a person who already applied for PR with all the relevant documents. Here you can see he has already uploaded 29 documents relevant to his work experience in order to avoid any delay or further contact by the CO. Hope you would have submitted all your experience documents during the skill assessment. So I would recommend you to resubmit the documents again to avoid any further delay. Hope this answers your question and all the best for your PR processing. Come, let's move on to the next question. The next question is from Renuka and she's asking, what are the chances for offshore applicant for 189 or 190 with 85 and 90 points respectively for software engineering category? As there are more questions on this particular job code from different people, I would like to answer this question in detail. Firstly, for 189 visa, the latest cutoff score as of March 2020 is 95 points. And as you all know that due to this COVID, there was a significant drop in the number of invitations sent out by DHA, which in turn increased the wait time for the applicants to receive the invite. This in turn caused both increase and decrease in the point system due to age and experience. So when Australia resumes the invitation for this particular job code, then the high priority and the chances would be only for 195 pointers to receive the invite within 1 to 3 months of time. And for 90 and 85 pointers, it may take almost 12 months to 18 months of time to receive the invite. Also, please note that this wait time might increase based on the invitation sent by DHA and the number of people waiting in pipeline, and thirdly on the immigration policy updates that happens every year. Let me explain you with some examples and evidences that I collected from different sources. Here you can see a person has posted the same question with points breakdown, saying that he is having 85 points without sponsorship, with 5 years of experience under the same skill code of software engineering as an offshore applicant with EOI launched as of 2nd December 2020, and is asking, is there any chance of 189 or 190? Here is another example or update from an offshore applicant who has applied for EOI in Jan 2020 with 85 points under the same skill code of 261313. So this is as of December 2020. So its wait time was 12 months and it might increase based on the current trend. And coming to the next example or update, you can see a person has raised a question that is waiting as an offshore applicant with 90 points for 189. And you can see another person has updated saying that there are so many numbers waiting on 90 and 400 EOIs on 95 for 189. We can just ignore the numbers mentioned here as there are no authenticity on the data. But two things that we can take from here is, one, there are minimum of 10 people waiting under 100 and 100 people waiting under 95 and minimum of 500 people waiting under 90 points. Secondly, when the invitation process resumes, higher priority would be given to the 100 and 95 pointers, followed by 90 and 85 points in the sequence. Finally, here is an example or evidence of 190 visa. Here you can see a person has already applied for 189 with 90 points and 190 with 95 points and got invited within 1 week of time under 190 visa, and he is an onshore applicant. As you all know, 190 visa is a state specific and it has some special conditions applicable. So it is mostly for onshore applicants, and if you are applying as an offshore, then there are chances only when you have an offer letter from any of the employers in Australia. Note, these timelines and onshore offshore availability may change any time based on the updates from any of the states or DHA. Hope this helps you to understand the timeline and cutoff points for 189 and 190 visas. Moving on to the next question, which is from Amit, and is asking that, I am an offshore candidate from India and my profile is age 31 with 30 points, education 15 points, experience 15 points, English 10 points and partner 5 points. Total is having 75 points and along with regional nomination is having 90 points. So his question is, please anyone suggest, is there any chances for getting a nomination from NSW under 491 for 90 points? Firstly, I would like to thank Amit for giving the clear breakdown of the points, and before answering to his question, let us consolidate and see the other questions under mechanical engineer category. So here is the other question from Kushang. Is asking, any chances for offshore mechanical engineers? I have my own 70 points plus regional points of 15. Which state do you suggest for mechanical engineering? And the other question is from Avinash, and his question is, what is the minimum points required to get subclass 190? To summarize, the first question is whether the person is eligible to get invite under regional visa in NSW for 90 points, and the second question is under which state he is eligible to get the invite for 90 points, and third question is what is the minimum points required for 190 visa. So from the screen you can see that the minimum or the latest cutoff score for mechanical engineering under 189 visa is 95 points, and similarly for 491 visa the minimum cutoff score is 95 points, and the visa date of effect for 189 is March 3rd, and similarly for 491 visa, their visa date of effect is November 2019. Let us consider this post as an example or evidence under mechanical engineering category. He has clearly given the points breakdown that he is having 90 points under 189 visa. He has initially applied for EOI in the month of March in 2020, and again he has updated the EOI in 2nd December. He has already waited in the queue for 9 months with 85 points, and then he updated the EOI again with additional 5 points and is again in the queue with 90. And here you can see the other person was posted saying that with 95 points and onshore waiting since September. This is as of December he has updated this, with 95 points each in the queue for last 3 months. This clearly shows that there was no invite for mechanical engineers in the last quarter of 2020. Here is the latest updated NSW subclass 491 occupational list, and it has mechanical engineer availability in all the regional areas, and you are good to apply in 2021, and there are high chances to get invited under mechanical engineering category with 90 points. Hope this gives you an insight about the wait time and point score required for 189 and 491 visa under mechanical engineer category. Hope these answers help you. Please continue to post your questions on the comment sections, and I would be more than happy to help you. Thanks again. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.